America has marked the 19th anniversary of the September 11 attacks, but this year commemorations were scaled back due to coronavirus. The smaller services were a reminder of how the US stared down another deadly crisis in 2001 that changed the country and the world forever. Our US correspondent Eamon Ashton Atkinson reports from New York.
A bell echoes in Lower Manhattan at 8:46 a.m., the exact moment when the first plane hit. 19 years on, only family members were allowed at America's most hallowed memorial thanks to another deadly tragedy gripping the US.
Michael Rourke Andrews.
A recording read out the names of those who died instead of loved ones. Wesley Miller was working search and rescue that day. He didn't find any survivors, only bodies.
All the people that got burnt up and suffered and tortured. Those are the real heroes, those names right there.
Ordinarily, Ground Zero would have been packed today, but the streets were empty, just like they were back then.
The changes to today's commemorations were an unwelcome reminder of how New York City has again been brought to its knees, this time by the coronavirus. But today was also proof that the city can recover, even from the most unimaginable tragedies.
President Trump and Joe Biden suspended their campaigns, paying their respects in Pennsylvania, where Flight 93 crashed.
In their last act on this earth, they saved our capital.
Joe Biden dropped off beer at a firehouse and travelled to Ground Zero, where he met a victim's mother.
Girl, lost mine. Never goes away.
Before bumping into Vice President Mike Pence, hardly the sleepy Joe Donald Trump paints him to be.
Possibly drugs involved, that's what I hear. I mean, there's possibly drugs.
And with so much division in America, today was a reminder of the good that can come when the country comes together, even in the most trying of times. Eamon Ashton Atkinson for 10 News First, New York.